A very good evening and a warm welcome to Father Sebastian, the Principal, Christ Junior College, Father Peter M.V., Vice Principal, Christ Junior College, and Principal, Christ Evening College, our facilitator for today, Ms. Michelle Alam Shah, my esteemed colleagues, and all the participants. Thank you all for joining this Department of Counseling initiative, Vivideza, a promoting well-being through the expressive arts. Expressive arts is a discipline of helping and healing that uses the arts as its basis for discovery and change. All the five disciplines of art, visual, dance or movement, music or drama, theatre, writing or poetry can give you a richer vocabulary to work, play, and grow a life you love living. You do not need to be an artist. The processes are simple. No previous art background is needed to help open the senses and access our imagination so we can find our own resources that we hold within us and that our art brings to us. I hope each and every one of you enjoys this session with us today and takes away something useful from it. A few pointers. Please put all the questions you have in the chat box. We will address all the questions after the session. There will be a link for the feedback form in the chat box. Kindly fill it after the session. Do put on your video at the end of the session for photographs and keep your audio muted during the session. Now, without much further ado, I would like to call upon Mrs. Ruth Kumal Jose to introduce our facilitator for today, Ms. Michelle Alam Shah.
A very good evening to you all and a warm welcome. This evening is all set up to unfold a starburst of colors promoting well-being through the expression of art. We, the Department of Counseling and the management of Christ Junior College, are extremely delighted to welcome Ms. Michelle Alam Shah, who is our resource person for this evening. She is a UNESCO-certified expressive arts facilitator for the past 4 years. She has conducted workshops on hope, self-care, trauma, communication, and emotional expression. She has worked with Higher Power Foundation, St. Joseph's Indian School, Creative Movement Therapy Association of India, and NIDISHA, with the purpose of encouraging expression and continuing the dialogue of mental health. She runs Expressive Daydreaming, an initiative where she promotes mental health and encourages mindful expression. She also does a lot of work on energy healing. In the current scenario, she has been conducting regular sessions on life force energy, positivity, self-awareness, Eastern healing practices, and making use of the art. Miss Michelle, it's with immense joy that I extend a very warm welcome to you this evening. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you for the introduction and thank you everyone for being here. I think it's a great honor and a privilege to be able to be in this space and to be able to talk about expressive arts and to be able to conduct this session. I hope that I am clearly audible. In case there's any issue, please feel free to let me know. So with that, I think if everyone is comfortable, I'll start the session, unless there's anything else that we have to do or discuss. Okay, so I think I'll start. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate the introduction, as I said, but I had a slightly different way or idea of introducing myself. and this is what it is. So I'm going to just share my screen for a moment, and here you are. Okay, so I hope that everybody can see this. Okay.
Yes, we can.
Okay, perfect. So this is, if I had to introduce myself, this is how I would introduce myself. I am not an artist, as Lisa ma'am said, you know, expressive arts is not about being an artist. It's not about having it all together. It's about doing very simple things to express ourselves. And these are some of the things that I did. And I thought that since it's an expressive arts session, what better way than to introduce myself through this? A lot of people, you know, I'm sure are wondering what this session is about. I think we had a question as well about what this session is about. And I'm going to briefly orient everyone to exactly that. So unlike art, where there is a standard, people expect you to be good, people expect you to use certain artistic techniques and training to be able to put something down on paper, expressive arts is not about that at all. It is just about expressing yourself using different mediums. It's about focusing on yourself, and that is really what the session is about today, about focusing on yourself. As I said, in case there are certain materials that you don't have, that's perfectly fine. We work with what we have and what's available to us. I'm going to do some very short activities for everyone to be a little oriented to expressive arts and see what it's all about. As I said, it's about expression. It's about you. It's about expressing your feelings. And I really hope that there is something that everyone can take away from this session. And if I had to tell everyone anything, I would say that in this session, at least, be yourself, everyone is already taken. That's what Oscar Wilde said, and that's what I truly believe as well. So I will stop sharing my screen and come back here. I have a poem which is actually a very, very simple poem by Nikita Gill. She is a British Indian poet. And the reason why I really like her poetry is because it's not complex. It's very simple. So if I have to sum up what this session is going to be about, it's going to be in this poem, which is a 5-line poem. I'm going to quickly read it out so that everyone knows what we're doing here. Okay, so the title of the poem is The Well-Spoken Heart. And here I go. The less you listen to the whispered words of your gentle heart, the more you choose to ignore it. The more you build the kind of wall around it that no one can climb to get to hold it. Instead, listen to what it wants and let it tell you what it needs. And you will find it growing roots and thriving when you plant these mystical seeds. The reason why, you know, I felt that this poem would be very appropriate, especially at this time, is because there's a lot going on around us with this pandemic. There's a lot that we're exposed to in our environment. And I really want to bring focus back to ourselves, to yourself. What we need right now, how we're feeling right now. I told someone the other day that if you're okay, if you're feeling okay through all of this, then we have a problem. Because it is very natural and very organic for us to feel a lot of things during this time. And if we can start to listen to how we're feeling, if we can start to listen to what we need, then automatically our experience becomes a lot more centered. And that's what expressive arts is really about. So before, you know, I do anything else, we come back to what makes us feel alive, what makes us present here right now, and that is our breath. Sometimes we ignore it. We don't give it enough importance or attention. So we're going to spend the next 2 minutes just focusing on our breath. for any activity that I do during the session, I'm going to also do it. So in case anyone feels that they haven't understood, you can just look at me and follow me or copy me or whatever you feel comfortable with. So this is, sorry, someone say something? Okay. So this is a simple breathing exercise. All I want everyone to do is close their eyes. Just close your eyes and take a deep breath in. Just take a deep breath in. And breathe out. Okay. Now, as you breathe in, try and really slow it down. Slow your breath down as you breathe in and slow it down as you breathe out, as slowly as you possibly can. Just slow your breath down. Bring focus here to your breath. Don't think about the fan, don't think about the light, don't think about anything. Just try and bring focus inward. We're going to do this 3 more times. Breathe in and breathe out very, very slowly at your own pace, of course. And as you breathe in, try and focus just on your breath, nothing else. And as you breathe out, try and let go of any tension or anything that you're holding from today. You know, maybe earlier today someone irritated you. Maybe you had some experience you didn't really like. So just try, and as you breathe out, just try and let it out of your body. Just try and let it go. And as you breathe in, bring focus again just to your breath. So 3 times we'll do this and then we'll move on. So I hope everyone's ready. We'll start. Take a deep breath in again. And breathe out. Once more. Breathe out. Last time. Okay. Notice what happens to our bodies when we breathe in and out. For example, right now I just noticed that when I breathe in, I take my hands up, and when I breathe out, I put my hands down. That wasn't intended. It's just how my body's moving. So we'll do this once more. Try and notice if there are any changes in your body or how you react when you breathe in and when you breathe out. Okay, last time. Breathe in. Okay, so this is a simple, it takes 30 seconds, 1 minute to do this. But what it does is it really slows our mind down. It slows our system down. It slows our body down. You know, it just brings immediate calmness. And I think that this is really, if I had to start this session with anything, it would be to say thank you to my breath. And, you know, for you all to say thank you to your own breaths, because that's how we're here. That's why we're present here. We neglect it sometimes, but it's really, really important. So whenever you get a chance and, you know, you feel that there's a lot of irritation or you're just dealing with a lot of negative emotions, just take a minute or two to breathe and hopefully you'll feel a little bit better. Okay, so now that we have acknowledged our breath, what I really want to bring focus to is each other. So I know that a lot of people's cameras are off, and if you prefer that, that's fine. If you want to switch it on for a second, that's fine as well. But what I want everybody to do is just extend their hands onto their screen or onto their camera, wherever. Just extend your hands forward, just for us to acknowledge each other. I know that there are lots of people here. I can't see anybody, and that's absolutely okay. But this is like a virtual hug. We're just extending some kind of virtual hug to everyone here and saying thank you for being here. And we're grateful for everyone who's a part of this experience. And that's not just me, that's everybody. So take 5 seconds. Let's just keep our hands forward. Virtual hug to everybody. So I think that's very important. You know, another thing that I talk about when I talk about expressive arts, it's about space. It's about the people we're surrounded by. Sometimes, you know, it doesn't hurt to be kind to the people who are around, who are present for us. And this is just a simple act of kindness. If you want to do it in your other sessions, you totally can. I think it's, again, a very short thing, but extending some kind of gratitude to the people who are here. And finally, we come to ourselves. So I'm hoping that everyone does have some paper. We're going to do a 5-minute activity. You can pick up any sheet of paper you have, whether it's an A4 sheet or an A3 sheet, or even if it's a small sheet of paper, whatever you have, whatever size you have. And what I want everyone really to do is look at this paper and imagine that you have to put yourself down there. So if I ask you, who are you? Or if I ask you to tell me a little bit about yourself, what would you draw or write or sketch on this paper that it depicts you? So I'll give you an example so that it's easier and it doesn't seem very random. Something that I did myself a few days ago was this. If someone asked me to draw myself on paper, this is what I would do. For some people, this may seem really weird, trying to understand what this could mean. But as I said, expressive arts is not about interpretation, it's about expression. So if someone asked me to put myself down on paper, this is what I'd do. And I want everyone to just see, I know it's not something we do often. I know it may take a little bit getting used to try and depict ourselves on paper. But we'll take 5 minutes and just see if you can, you know, you can write. You can even just write your name if you feel most comfortable with that. But write, color, paint, draw, anything to depict yourself on this sheet of paper. So we'll start, and in 5 minutes, we'll all come back here. So I'll bring that back. But take 5 minutes. I'll do it myself as well. And take 5 minutes and just see how you would depict yourself on paper. Really try and use color. you know, just if you have any kind of crayons or color pencils, see if there's any color that stands out for you that you think, okay, this is my color. This color depicts who I am. Try and experiment. See what you connect to, what colors, what shapes, what words resonate with who you are. Okay, let's come back. So I know that, you know, it's possible that everyone hasn't finished this. I think no one can really put a time to who we are. But for the sake of the session, I think we're going to pause here. In case, you know, you feel that there's more that you want to write down, there's more that you want to color, paint, whatever it is, it's something that you can revisit after this session. But for now, let's just pause here and come back. So anyone who feels comfortable sharing, maybe you can just switch on your camera for a few seconds and show us. You don't have to say anything. It's just something that you can show us if you feel comfortable.
Can I? I would want to show.
You would want to show?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, perfect, perfect. So you can switch on your camera and just show us.
Can you see?
Yes, oh, yes, I can totally see that.
So I don't know, it's just like a representation of a spring. And it has yellow, orange, pink. I don't know, just making me... And you asked to represent myself, so I'm just a very happy person and I like talking to people, new people. So okay. This is what I represented myself.
Okay, thank you so much for sharing. And if there's anyone else, you know, we don't even have to get into an explanation. Of course, if you'd like to share, perfect, but because time is... of the essence, maybe you could just show us, like switch your videos on and show us. So this is something that I did. And don't ask me to explain, because as I said, I don't know where this comes from and why I did this. But this is what I did. And I see that there are other people who are also sharing. Perfect, perfect. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Okay, so I'm really glad. You know, the thing is that sometimes someone may ask you to talk about yourself and you may think, what am I supposed to say? Like, okay, I'm a girl. woman. This is my age. This is where I went to school. This is what I do. But, you know, it's very hard sometimes. And it's also not real. It's not who we really are. It's easy for us to identify our identity with, you know, which class you're in or what your gender is or where your house is and things like that. But who we really are sometimes comes out through other forms of expression. And this is something that, as I said, if you want to come back to revisit, you totally can. I showed you something I did the other day. Today, it's something completely different. So I genuinely believe that we're not just one kind of person and we don't just have to represent ourselves through one thing, but it's something that you can continue doing as and when you feel like it. So yeah, so that's what I really wanted us to look into. So far, I think just to quickly sum up, we've done a simple breathing activity. We've acknowledged each other and we've acknowledged ourselves on some kind of paper in some form of expression. Now what I really want everyone to turn to is their feelings. How are you feeling right now? Not today, not during the pandemic, but just right now. You don't have to share it. Just think, take a minute to think about how you are feeling right now. Try and see if you can put a word to it. If you can try and identify what that feeling is right now or what those feelings are. Maybe there's not just one feeling, there are a couple of feelings. So take a minute and just try and identify. Turn within and see what's going on for you. How are you feeling right now in this very moment? So if I had to share, I'm feeling mildly nervous. I'm feeling very excited and I'm feeling a tad bit cold because of the weather. So that's how I'm feeling. Sometimes, you know, we all feel this urge to be happy all the time. Everyone's encouraging us to be happy. Everyone's encouraging us to be productive, especially in this pandemic. It's like people are putting up pictures on Instagram about how they're experimenting with this new food and they're cooking this, I mean, they're making this coffee and they're reading this new book and they're writing something and everyone just seems very happy and productive. But as I said, you know, there is so much that goes on inside of us. And if we're feeling okay or we're feeling happy all the time, then something's not right. We're not tapping into what we're truly feeling sometimes. And, you know, this is a session about well-being. And if I had to say anything about well-being, if I had to say anything about wellness, it's that we don't have to be happy all the time. We just have to be ourselves all the time, which is very, very hard because we were not taught to be like that. But that's what I'm really hoping we can do a little bit during this session. So, yeah, I always say that feelings are like visitors. So whether you're happy or you're sad or you're angry or you're upset or you're confused or numb or frustrated, it's going to come and it's going to go. Some days it may stay longer than you want it to, but eventually it will go. It has to go. And what I really want to bring focus to is, apart from how you're feeling in terms of a word, also how your body is feeling right now. So we did a breath activity. Now we're going to just bring focus to our entire body, right? So this is how we're going to do this. It's called a body scan. So what I want everyone to do is try and get a little comfortable. If you're, you know, try and see, find a comfortable spot. So if you're sitting cross-legged, is that comfortable for you? Try and just sit comfortably in a comfortable space. And we're going to do a body scan. Now, what this is everyone, I would recommend, close your eyes and take a quick scan from your head to your toe, right? So you say, for example, we start with our head. Just spend a few seconds with your head. You can either touch your forehead and your head, or you don't have to touch. You can just close your eyes and quickly just bring your attention and focus here. And just ask your head that, you know, how are you feeling? Are you tired? Are you heavy? Are you comfortable? And from your head, just scan through your body parts to see how your body is feeling. If something's uncomfortable, what can we do to make it a little bit more comfortable? If you need to stretch your back so that your back feels a little comfortable. So just do a quick, we're going to take 2 minutes. Everyone can do their own quick body scan to just see how their body is feeling and what we can do, change, turn a little bit to feel a little bit more comfortable in our body. So just take these 2 minutes, and I'll do this as well. As I said, you can touch or you don't have to, but try to not neglect any body part. Show your body a little bit of care, a little bit of love. Give yourself a little bit of a hug when you're scanning your arms and your shoulders. Try and touch every finger, every nail. Don't leave anything behind. Don't leave anything out. If you feel that there is something that you normally neglect, show it a little bit more love. If I feel that, oh, I haven't touched these parts of my ears ever, let me spend a little bit more time there. Your body is you. So spend some time just bringing focus to that. See if there's any part of your body that needs a little bit more attention, a little bit more care. And when you feel that you have spent a little bit of time with your body, when you have done that scan, then come back. Come back to the session once you feel that you have heard your body. Take another minute if you think there's something you haven't listened to yet, and then come back. Okay, so let's come back. So if you ever feel that, you know, you're in the middle of an activity, for example, this body scan, you feel like you haven't reached your toe, you've gotten stuck at your knee and you haven't had the time to go down, you can always revisit it. But as I said, for the session, we're going to come back. So to not get stuck there, you can do an easy just breathe to come back here, or just, you know, shake it off a little bit, move your body a little bit just to come back here, refocus yourself and recenter yourself here. I am hoping that we don't have any internet problems, but in case that does at all happen in the session or you lose me for a minute or 2 minutes, then you can revisit your body scan, you can revisit yourself on paper. So you can go back to those activities, and you can even go back to the activities after the session. But for now, everyone, just come back here. Okay, so the reason why we're looking at our feelings, the reason why we're looking at our body, is because if we don't feel comfortable, it's very difficult for us to express ourselves. So imagine, you know, being surrounded by somebody who you know, who you feel very uncomfortable with. They just don't make you feel comfortable. You don't want to be in that space. Either they judge you a lot or they're very critical of you or something like that, you know. It's very difficult then for us to be our true selves. One of the prerequisites for us to be our true selves and really express who we are is comfort. To be comfortable in the space, for our body to be comfortable, for our minds to be at ease, for us to be comfortable with our own feelings. So it's very important sometimes to look at what makes us feel comfortable. And one of the things that I would also recommend is try and see or find a space in your house where you feel comfortable. It can be anything. It can be a corner of a room. It can be an entire room. It can even be something that makes me feel really comfortable. When I'm having a bad day, I actually go and sit on the ground in my washroom. That makes me feel comfortable. That's my comfortable space. So comfort, very important. Don't disregard it. It's important to feel comfortable. You know, I think sometimes we try to challenge ourselves and we try to do these different things, which is great, but it's important and it's okay to be comfortable, especially when you want to express ourselves. And if I have to talk about comfort, I can't not talk about the people in our lives. And that really brings me to what we're going to do next. I want everyone to take 2 minutes and try and identify the people who they feel comfortable with, the people who you can be yourselves with, who you can express yourself with. You don't feel judged. You don't feel that they're being critical. You don't feel that you have to hide yourself. You don't feel that you ever have to wear a single mask. You can just be your true, authentic self. It can be one person, it can be three people, it can be five people, but even one is amazing. So someone or some people who you feel safe with, who you feel comfortable with. Take a minute and just reflect on that and write those names down. Write those names down of the people who you feel comfortable with. Okay, let's come back, shake it off. So I am hoping that for everyone, they can identify at least one person they feel comfortable with. This is not to say that, oh, we should cut off everyone else from our lives. But this is really to try and identify what are some of our safe spaces. And in case there is anyone here who wasn't able to think of even a single person they feel safe with, try and identify maybe not a person, but a thing or a smell or a piece of clothing that makes you feel comfortable. It could be a movie that you watch, which just makes you feel completely comfortable. It could be the smell of something, as I said, you know, anything that just makes you feel a little bit safe. I was reading this book, which I must show you all. So I'm not a reader. I'm honestly not the biggest reader, but I really like some of the stuff that people say when they make it very simple and they're not trying to complicate what they're saying. So one of the books that I've been reading is this. And the title of this book is Only Love is Real. And it's not about love in a romantic sense. But he does talk about soulmates, this Dr. Brian Weiss. He talks about soulmates. And basically what he says is that a soulmate is not someone who is going to be your everything for the rest of your life. A soulmate is someone, when you look in their eyes, you can see your soul reflecting back at you. And a soulmate is not going to be this one romantic partner. It could be a friend. It could be a taxi driver. It could be anyone who you feel a deep personal connection with at that time. And the other thing he says is that sometimes soulmates come and go. You know, you have a connection with someone. They make you feel very comfortable. They make you feel really safe. And then, you know, they move on, you move on, and you find another soulmate. So, it's okay if there are people who you're close to who don't make you feel that comfortable. But what you want to focus on is that when something like this happens, when there is, I mean, hopefully there will not be another pandemic, but when we're all facing trouble, when we're having a bad day, when we're going through a difficult time, who are the people who you can talk to? Who are the people who you feel comfortable with and that you can just be yourself with? So that was about people. We're going to do one last activity and then I'm going to take like a minute's break just to gather everything. I don't want to go too fast. So we're going to do this one last thing and then we'll take a minute's break just to make sure that, you know, we're not doing too much. So the next thing that I'm going to introduce you all to is something called a writing stem. So it's where writing and words comes into expressive arts. What we're going to do is now take another sheet of paper. If you have a rule sheet, perfect. But if you don't have a rule sheet, that's okay as well. And we're going to write 5 sentences. Okay, 5 sentences that are going to start with the words I still. Okay, so I still dot, dot, dot. Whatever. Now, the reason why we're doing this is because during this pandemic, everything has been all over the place. Everything feels like it's changed. Our routine has changed. Our experiences have changed. Our impacts have changed. Our feelings may have changed. Our thoughts may have changed. Our relationships may have even changed. But through all of this, what is still constant for you? What are you still doing? One of the things I wrote the other day is I still get excited by home-cooked food. So what are some of the things which are still the same, even with the world changing around us, the people around us changing ourselves, evolving, growing? What is still the same? What's constant? So we're going to take 2 minutes and try and write down 5 sentences. Each sentence should start with I still. And I already gave an example. I'll give you another one. I still look out the window when it's raining and, you know, rain still makes me happy. So any 5 things, don't think too much about it. The thing with writing is that we don't want to think too much about what we're writing. Just write. Whatever's coming to your mind, whatever thoughts are coming, just put it down. Don't judge yourself. Don't be critical of what you're thinking. Just put it down. So 5 sentences that start with, I still. 2 minutes. Okay, let's come back. Again, shake it off a little bit, come back here. So about writing, there are lots of people who say, you know, when you're having a hard time, write your thoughts down. And I would also encourage that. Sometimes just writing down things in a journal or just writing down how you feel really lets some of that out of your system. You know, anything that could possibly be stuck, whether it's a feeling or a thought, it just lets a lot of it out. Sometimes, though, we struggle with writing. So if someone told me that, you know, you're having a bad day, just write down sheets and sheets of paper, sometimes I feel, where am I supposed to start? And in these situations, a writing stem really helps. So it's like a guide, you know. So if you want to feel happy or you want to reflect on what's made you happy, you can write sentences that start with, I feel happy when. Or if you want to reflect on anything, it can, you know, what are some of the things you could do during this pandemic? It can be, I could, you know, and just write sentences of the different things that you could do or different experiences you could have. So it's just a guiding principle. One of the first few people who spoke about writing therapy and as a therapeutic form is this person called James Penney Baker. And he basically said that the idea is not write pages and pages and pages every day. The best thing is to use a writing stem like this, a sentence stem like this. The other option, which he said, is that when you're going through a bad time, you know, you have any kind of experience in life, which is affecting you a lot, he said, write for 20 minutes for 4 days. So for 4 days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, write for 20 minutes each day. Not more than that, not less than that. And according to him, that is the estimated time where you will be able to express a lot of things without, you know, getting obsessed or getting stuck with them. So that's what he said, and that's really what I wanted to orient you all to. When I'm having a bad day, it really comes down to writing. And writing can be really powerful because, again, some people don't like color. Some people don't like art. Sometimes to visualize yourself on paper seems really difficult. So in those situations, words really help. And if English is not your first language and it's something else, you can even write in that language. It does, as I said, it's not about showing anyone. It's not about, you know, being the best writer. I mean, one of the things I just wrote is I still don't read that much. So it's not about, you know, being impressive at all. It's just about being true to yourself. So yeah, so this I really wanted to just introduce everybody to some basics of expressive arts, as well as some basic activities that we can do to feel a little bit more comfortable, to bring focus internally. So at this point, I'm going to just take a 1 minute break, exactly 1 minute. Everything that we have done so far, maybe just reflect on it. You know, if there is something that you had left midway, you know, you can revisit it, go back to it, just take it all in before we move forward. I don't want, as I said, don't want to go too fast. So just take it all in, reflect a little bit, see how everything that we've done so far has made you feel. And again, just come back after 1 minute, focusing on comfort. So take this 1 minute. Okay, so let's come back. So far, my focus really has been on trying to orient everyone to expressive arts, to bring about some form of awareness, whether that's through our breath, through our feelings, through ourselves, through the body scan, and to build some comfort spaces, right? How we physically feel comfortable, the people who make us feel comfortable, you know, what are some of the anchors? What are some of the constant things that have, you know, been the same through this lockdown, through this pandemic? Now we're going to move a little bit more into expression, into emotional expression. at this point, I have to say that I really want everyone to have a good time. I really want fun to be an important element. But I think that I also want the focus to be on our emotions, on our expression. And sometimes that's not fun. Sometimes it's a bit hard for some of us to do. But once we do it, we feel a little bit lighter. So I would encourage everyone to keep an open mind to expression. Try really to express yourself in the next few activities for, say, the next half an hour. Try to really express yourself and be as honest and true to yourself as you possibly can. The important part, again, is that you don't have to, no one else is looking at you. It's not interpretation, just expression. So just go for it. And if you don't feel comfortable, don't force yourself to do anything. Just try and see if you can gain some kind of comfort through the activities that follow. So the first thing that we're going to do is what's called an emotional spectrum or an emotion spectrum exercise. These are some of the emotions or the feelings rather that I thought of. Earlier what we had done is we had written down or we had just spent a moment to reflect on how we were feeling right now. Now what we're going to do is think about these past 4 months or 5 months of the pandemic, of the lockdown, and see what are some of the feelings that we have had. What are some of the feelings that have visited us in the past 4 or 5 months? So the first part of this is, again, just take a sheet of paper, as big as small, and just write down the feelings that have visited you and the feelings that you have experienced. Don't have to do anything, just identify them and write them down on a sheet of paper. So just take a couple of minutes and just write those feelings down on a sheet of paper. And I'll tell you what to do after that, but for now, just write down whatever feelings have visited you and whatever you have felt in the past few months. Okay, so these are some of the feelings that have visited me. Okay, I'm hoping everyone can see this. These are some of the feelings that have visited me, right? I'll read them out quickly. There's guilt, hope, joy, jealousy, irritation, and boredom. So these are some of the feelings that I have experienced in the past 4 months. Now, if you asked me, Michelle, how are you feeling? Or how were you feeling? I would feel very uncomfortable to say jealousy because I haven't felt intense jealousy. So the purpose of this activity really is to try and identify how much of that emotion are we actually feeling. Sometimes we feel uncomfortable to put a name to how we're feeling because it's very little or it's about 50%. So what we're going to do now is if you have written down the feelings that you have had, we're going to start to color them based on how much we have experienced it. So I'll give you a quick example. If I said I have experienced jealousy very little bit, I'm going to color it out like this, very little. If I have experienced hope a lot, I'll color hope, that one was hope, a lot more. So take again a couple of minutes and look at the feelings you have written down and color them out based on their intensity or how much you have felt them. 2 minutes. Sorry, I was on mute. So just to show you, this is mine. And in case anyone else wants to share, they can. You don't have to say anything. You can switch on your video for just a few seconds and show us. And if you don't want to, then that's fine as well. Thank you everyone for sharing. I don't think I said this when some people shared their self-association page. It's not easy to share your feelings. It's not easy to express yourself to complete strangers, even if you know each other and you don't know me at all, or you don't know a lot of people. It's not easy. And I want to thank everyone for really sharing, for really expressing themselves. So thank you so, so much, everybody. Take that moment. In fact, everyone, take a moment to thank yourself for being so true to your expressions and what you're going through right now. So take that moment, look at your sheet of paper, and just take a moment to thank yourself. Share some love internally. Just spend 30 seconds sharing some love internally and thank yourself for being so honest and open and expressive. There is this quote by someone, I found it on Instagram, Christopher Poindexter, something like that. And he said that you feel so much because you are so much. And that's something that I really want to tell everyone. We judge ourselves a lot for the feelings we have. Other people sometimes judge us as well. But the reason why you're feeling so many things is because you are not this small, but you are so much. So that's something that I really want to tell everybody. And if you take away anything and remember anything I said, remember this, that the reason why you have so many feelings, the reason why you have so many thoughts is because you are so much. And while some of those feelings we like, and we want to keep them in our home, some of those we also may want to let go of. So if you have space on the same sheet, or if you want to take another sheet, we're going to turn to another writing exercise. Here, we're going to again write 5 sentences, but the previous sentence stem was I still. The sentence stem now is I want to let go of. So again, don't think about it. Don't judge yourself. This I won't ask anyone to share at all. So try and be as honest as you possibly can and write 5 sentences. Take 2 minutes, write 5 sentences that start with I want to let go of. Okay, coming back, have a look at whatever you have written down so far. Even if you've only been able to write 1 sentence or 3 or 5, have a look at those sentences. And what I want everyone now to do is to stand up. Put the sheet down, wherever, on the floor, on the bed, on the table, and just stand up. Just stand up. I'm going to try and, okay. So stand up, and what we're going to do is we're going to try and brush off all the things that we want to let go of. We're going to try and brush them off our body. So we're going to do this for 1 minute, only 1 minute. I'm going to look at the timer. We won't do this for any longer. Just stand up, and we're going to try brushing it off our body. So it starts with something as simple as this. Just brush off your body. And as you brush off, you want to say leave. Okay. So brush it off. You can brush it off from anywhere. But you want to say as you brush it off, leave. Leave. Okay. So we're going to start. And for 1 minute straight, all we're going to do is brush off anything that's stuck, anything that's unwanted that you want to let go of. We're going to just brush it off, and we're going to tell it to leave. Okay, and we're going to start now. Leave. 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 Depending on how you feel, you can say it louder or softer. But try and brush off anything that you're holding on to, any toxicity, any feelings you want to let go of, thoughts that are annoying you, that are adding negativity into your life. Tell them to just leave. Leave. Move if you want a little bit. You can jump, you can walk around. Put in as much energy as you want to in this. Just tell it to leave. 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 And as you feel that you're seeing it, try and say it softer and softer as you go along. So leave. Start being gentler to yourself. Leave. Leave. Bring focus to your breath. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take another deep breath in. Start being gentler with your body. Leave. Softer. Bring focus inward. Take a few more breaths. Just come back. See how you're feeling, how your body is feeling. Try and come back into some kind of a comfortable position for now. Breathe. Shake off anything that feels stuck. Focus on your breathing, focus on yourself. Give yourself a little bit of a hug. Breathe. Now we come back to sentences and take a fresh sheet of paper. And instead of number of sentences, we're going to have a time this time. So I'm going to give everyone 5 minutes. There's no limit on sentences. You can write as many or as few. This time, the sentence stem is, I feel free when, and I feel alive when. So these are the two sentence stems. Write as many sentences as you want in the next 5 minutes that start with these. We have said goodbye to some toxicity, to some negativity. We have let go of some of the things that we're holding on to. Now we want to bring focus back on what makes us feel alive, what makes us feel free. So take 5 minutes and write as much as you want to, as much as you possibly can, that start sentences that start with these words. Five minutes. you know, sometimes we have experiences, we go through things and we hold on to that. We're holding on to it and it's stuck. It's like that feeling has built a home in us. But I love this quote, which says that these mountains that you are carrying, you were only supposed to climb. So there's all of this that as people were carrying in our lives, we're carrying these heavy bags with all this baggage and all these rocks, which we were just meant to experience, you know. And I wish that I could say there's a simple way of letting those feelings or those thoughts go. But there isn't, you know, and it is a process, and we do different things, whether it's painting or writing or moving, to really feel lighter, to feel a little bit more comfortable, and to turn love inward. So for everyone, if you have a mirror in front of you, then I want you to stand in front of the mirror. And if you don't have a mirror in front of you, I want you to just close your eyes. And I want you to say, I love you to yourself 3 times. Even if you don't feel it right now, say it anyway. Just tell yourself that I love you. And once you have done that, I want everyone to just come back to a comfortable position, close their eyes, and just listen. We're going to try and find our comfortable space, our comfortable spot. So just come back, find a comfortable space, close your eyes. You don't have to do anything, just listen. Take a deep breath in and breathe out and just listen. Find your favorite spot. Imagine that you are in the most comfortable place, surrounded by positivity. Surrounded by positive feelings, surrounded by positive thoughts. You could be indoors or outdoors. It could be a small place or a large place. But just try and imagine your comfortable space, your most comfortable spot. Are you alone there, or are there other people with you? Are there any animals or birds? What can you smell? What can you touch? Imagine that the weather is perfect and you're feeling really calm. You're feeling light. You're feeling calm. You're just feeling at peace. You have no worries, no concerns. You can just relax and be yourself. Think about what you can see, what you can feel. Just spend 2 minutes being in your most comfortable spot. with all the sounds and the smell and the touch and the people, animals, birds, nature, weather, everything that makes you feel comfortable and at peace. Just spend 2 minutes in this place. Know that this place will always be there. It will be your comfort space. You can return to it whenever you want. And when you feel that you've experienced it and you're ready to file it away and come back to it someday, then just do that and come back. Come back here, come back to us. Take a deep breath. Come back here. You're not saying goodbye to that comfort space forever. You're just filing it away for a little bit and coming back here. Bring your focus back on your breath. Something that we did in the beginning, take a few breaths in and out. As you breathe in, bring focus to yourself here. As you breathe out, let go of some of the tension or some of the negative thoughts or anything that you're holding on to. Try and just let it go. Breathe in again. Bring focus to yourself. Give yourself a little bit of love, extra love today. And as you breathe out, just let it go. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in again. Breathe out. One last time, coming back here to everybody, breathe in. Breathe out. Okay, so I hope everyone is back here. I know it's not always easy to leave your comfort space. Maybe for some of you, it was even hard to visualize that space. Maybe some of you are thinking, what is she talking about? I can't imagine this place. So I'm sure everyone has different experiences. But the focus really is on coming back to comfort. Knowing that we can imagine that space, that we can create that space for ourselves, and we can return to that space if and when we want to. So I know that the last few activities, some of it was a little bit more expressive in terms of letting things go, in terms of that body activity that we did, leave. Then again, coming back to writing, I feel free when, I feel alive when. Then telling yourself that I love you, and then coming back to comfort. for some people, it may have been difficult, not easy. Some of you may not even have been able to do some of those because you just weren't able to relate to it or it didn't resonate with you. That's perfectly fine. So expressive arts is not about any stuck formula. It's not that this activity will work with everyone and it will always work. It's about what resonates with you, right? So sometimes art, like visual art, may resonate with someone more. Sometimes people find it easier to visualize, you know, and imagine a comfort space or things like that. Sometimes people feel easier to move. Sometimes the drama also helps. So we did the emotion spectrum, the, you know, writing it out and drawing it out. Sometimes, you know, maybe people who prefer drama or theater, you can even act it out. You can imagine that you're feeling that emotion, how much you're feeling it, and express it that way. So to each his own, really. It can be art, it can be writing, it can be movement, drama, storytelling, poetry. I think I've said a couple of quotes and even read the poem in the beginning because that also has a lot of power. A lot of strength comes sometimes just by reading someone else's words. And I don't know how many of you are on social media, but there are lots of people who are putting up a lot of positive content because there's a lot of toxicity there as well. There's a lot of toxicity in the news, on social media, Instagram, Facebook, all of that. So... but there are some people who are putting positive content. There are good books that, you know, sometimes just reading or watching a movie can make us feel a little better. So before I close the session, I'm going to quickly talk a little bit about a few quick expressive arts things that you can do by yourself whenever you want. It's a very quick, I'm going to walk you through it. And just show you, this is something you can just listen, you don't have to do, because I don't want to spend too much time on this. I just want to quickly go through this. It's what I call expressive arts giveaways. So some of the things which you can do when you're having a bad day or when you want to feel a little bit better. The first thing is to scribble. So if you scribble on a sheet of paper, it releases a lot of energy and it releases a lot of tension. So if you're ever feeling like you've had a bad day or you're feeling very heavy, sometimes just scribbling helps. Another thing that really helps is the breath activity, to really breathe. That really calms you down. Another way of calming down is to take a brush. So I don't know how many people have paint, but if you have paint and you have a brush, this is something that's very easy and something that you can do. Just put your brush, put it on, take a little paint and a little bit of water and imagine that you're brushing or whatever, you're painting your sheet of paper at the slowest rate that you possibly can. So really slow down your brush stroke. It will slow down your expression. It will slow down your hand, your body, your mind. So again, it brings calmness. So when it comes to visual art, whether it's scribbling, whether it's writing, doodling, can also really bring focus back to yourself. Even coloring, you know, I don't know, maybe you all, some people think that coloring is for kids, but now you have even, you know, coloring books for teenagers, coloring books for adults, which really brings focus on being calm and just on yourself. The other thing that I always say is to focus on music. A friend of mine recently told me that, don't you listen to music first thing in the morning? And I said, no, I don't listen to music first thing in the morning. I don't listen to music when I'm getting ready or anything like that. So he said, how do you not listen to music when you're getting ready? I don't know. I've just never done it. And a lot of us find a lot of calmness through music. It can be really powerful. Sometimes just listening to a song that makes you happy or just music that makes you feel comfortable can really, you know, bring focus internally. The other thing is how to feel confident. So one of the ways to feel confident is, again, let's go back to the sentence stems, is I think I can. So if you ever feel that, you know, you want to feel a little bit more confident, or you're unsure about a few things, or you feel like you're doubting yourself a little bit, you can just write sentences that start with, I think I can. Another thing which is very useful is the superhero pose. So, of course, the Superman pose is like that. But also just putting your hands on your hip, standing back straight, looking up, really helps. It decreases cortisol and makes you feel less stressed, more confident. So again, it's a quick way. You can even stand in that pose and visualize achieving something. It's something you can do. One of the things that I would mention is to take a picture or take pictures. I don't know how many of you have cameras or even phones with a camera. I'm sure someone has in your home, or you guys have yourself. So, you know, a quick walk, just walking around nature, taking pictures of things that make you feel comfortable, that make you feel happy, that make you feel calm. Again, always helps me on a bad day. Another thing, which is a trick that I tell everybody, is that when you're very, very angry and there's a lot of energy, there's a lot of built up energy, and that energy has to go somewhere. So sometimes people choose to hurt themselves. They choose to punch the wall, things like that. What you want to do is take a pillow or a cushion or a stuffed toy. So I have a stuffed toy in my house, which I'm showing you all. Okay. So take a stuffed toy, pillow, cushion, anything that's soft, anything that doesn't hurt, and throw it on the wall. Okay. It takes as much energy to throw that, and it will make you feel better. Do it many times if you feel that it helps. But again, you're directing your anger out, and you're really expressing it out of your system. So that is also a trick on a bad day, or when you're feeling very angry and you don't know what to do with that anger. Writing, as I said, is something that I always turn to, and it is an option. Looking out of the window, it's very weird, but sometimes just looking out of the window gives us perspective. We remember and remind ourselves that there is a world outside. So sometimes just looking out of the window, sometimes smiling at yourself, all of these things, you know, are very, very small things. We neglect them sometimes, but they bring focus to ourselves and they make us feel better. Even giving yourself a hug or telling yourself that you love yourself, all of that is, you know, will help you on a bad day and when things don't go well. And one of the things is, which again I tell some people, is to sleep on it. You know, sometimes we're having a bad day, we're going through all these feelings, and honestly, it's okay. Let yourself experience all that. Let yourself feel all those negative and positive feelings. Just sleep it off. When you wake up the next morning, if you're still feeling them, then of course you can always do something about it. But sometimes you may not be feeling them. The only reason why you were feeling them is because their feelings, they also want to be heard, you know, they also want to be listened to. Anger also wants to show up sometimes and say hi to you. So it's okay. Try not, I know this is the hardest thing, but something that I tell everyone is we want to try to be less critical of our feelings. Because the more we judge them, the longer they tend to stay. If we're able to let them be, they'll say tata and they'll leave at some point. So yeah, so those are some of the what I call expressive arts giveaways. One of the things which is homework for everyone is to make a lockdown memory. I don't know if you all have done that already or if anyone's ever spoken to you about that, but we perceive the pandemic and the lockdown very negatively. And I did this a couple of weeks ago. You can either take a picture or paint or write, or anything that's semi-expressive arts, write a poem if you're good at poetry, to remember this time. You know, something that you could put in a memory box, and 20 years from now or 10 years from now, that'll be your memory of the pandemic. Not all the inconveniences and all the negativity that came out, but something bright, something that symbolizes some kind of sunshine during this time. I'm not trying to insinuate that the negatives don't matter, but it's just to remember this time in a positive light and not only as something that we all suffered through or were struggling through. So that's my little bit of an expressive arts giveaway. And that brings us to the closure of the session. So when there's any expressive arts session, there's the beginning bit, which is focused on awareness. It's focused on acknowledging each other. It's focused on saying hello to our feelings. And this is the end of it, or the closure. So here again, we say bye to all of that. So the first thing, of course, is to say bye to each other, to acknowledge each other again. So again, everyone can put their hands on the camera or their laptop or computer or phone or whatever to just acknowledge everyone's presence again and say thank you. Thank you to everyone for being here. Thank you to everyone for being a part of this expressive journey with us all, and acknowledge everybody. So that's the first bit of it. The second bit, again, turn internally. Look at your body. Give yourself a little bit of a massage. See what are the, if your leg is hurting because, you know, you've been sitting in an uncomfortable space, if your back is hurting, you want to stretch that out, give yourself a little bit of a massage, give your body a little bit of love, just focus on it and just see what it needs to feel a little bit better and a little bit more comfortable. So give yourself a little bit of massage, move your head around, say thank you to your eyes for staring at a screen for so long. You know, thank you. I must say thank you to my mouth for being able to speak for so long. So really bring focus internal, focus on your body, give yourself a little bit of a massage. Just focus on your body. If you have time later, which again is a wonderful activity to do, is to dip your hands in warm water or cold water, and then just lightly tap your forehead, lightly tap your hands. I mean, you can do that to the rest of your body as well, but just your head and your eyes, maybe, and hands. Water is again a sensation that is generally pleasing. So it's about the temperature that you like, so you can make it warm or cold depending, and then just gently tap your forehead or your eyes, especially if you wake up in the morning and your eyes are hurting, just gently tap your eyes. So spend a minute and just focus on your body, see what it needs. Say thank you for being cooperative today for this session, and give it a little bit of a massage. Okay, now quick reflection, first on your feelings. Now that we have seen how our body's doing and we've gotten in touch with our body, bring focus to your feeling. How are you feeling right now? Are you still feeling heavy from any activity? Are you feeling a little lighter? Are you feeling like yourself? What are you feeling? And this is very, very important. If you're not feeling comfortable, if you're feeling heavy, if you're feeling something stuck, just focus, come back to the breathing, come back to yourself, really focus and see how you can feel a bit more comfortable right now. Very, very important, because you don't want to end the session feeling heavy and stuck. You want to end the session in your comfort space, feeling lighter. So see what you can just take a minute and really just take focus of what will give you comfort right now. And for everybody else, if you are in a comfortable space, I want you to really think and reflect on what are you taking away from this session. And if you could pick up any one thing and tell the world that, then what would you tell the world? You know, what is something that you have picked up yourself from this session that you want to remember, that you'd like to tell everybody? It doesn't have to even be something I said. It could be an experience you've had, but just something, just something you want to take away from the session. So we're going to spend the last minute on reflecting on our feelings and reflecting on what we want to take away from the session. So 1 minute, and then I'll say my last bit. So I started the session, or somewhere in the beginning of the session, I read out that poem, which I really like, to summarize what I wanted the session to be about. And I'm going to end with a quote in a book by Dr. Seuss. As I said, I'm not the biggest reader, but this is something that if I wanted everyone to remember, this is something I'd want everyone to remember. So this is it. It's just two lines. Bear with me, and then we'll end. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. And you are the one who'll decide where to go. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. So that's what I'd like everyone to remember. And with that, I think I am done. I'm hoping everyone's here and present. And thank you.
Thank you, Michelle, for a wonderful session. I'm sure there's a lot each of us can take home today. I'd encourage all the participants to put down your questions in the chat box. We'll be happy to take your questions and Michelle can answer them. I'd also request you all to kindly fill the feedback form, which is given in the chat box. The link is available. Please fill the feedback form as well. Thank you. Over to Sandra. I call upon Sandra Simon now to put forth whatever questions are there for today. Thank you.
All the participants, good evening to everyone. So if you have any questions, as Desa ma'am was saying, you can type it down and we can answer that. And Michelle, this is not a question. One student was saying, thank you, ma'am, had a wonderful time. That is by Shreya.
Thank you, Shreya. Thank you for that.
again, feedback from Soumya. Thank you for a lovely session, ma'am.
Thank you, Soumya.
Yeah, students, if you have any questions also, maybe regarding the topic, you can ask. Also, it's nice that you're sharing your feedback. So they're saying we were able to learn so many new things from you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, could you tell us what your favorite thing to do is when you are feeling down? That is a question from Vipa.
That's a tough one. One of the things that I love to do is to change my space a little bit. So either clean up my room or put up, I mean, these are things that I put up on my wall. I have on another wall all these pictures that I printed and put it up. So sometimes, you know, the best thing that works is to just change my space a little bit. I add a little color in my room. I'll, you know, put on some fairy lights. I'll smell jasmine because I really like the smell of jasmine. So these are some of the things that I really like to do. But if I had to pick one thing, I mean, even though I said the space thing, it would probably be writing. When I'm really feeling down, I write. And one of the things which, so especially if I'm having a, if I have a problem with someone, if someone else has hurt me, I write, say an email, or I write in my notebook, or I'll write whatever I'm feeling and I'll just write that down. Sometimes I don't send those emails. They're in my drafts folder, but it helps me to write things down so that I feel a little better.
Okay, there is another question from Rakshita. What is the benefit we gain from art?
What is the benefit we gain from art? See, the first thing, which is something that I spoke about earlier as well, is that art can be purely expressive. So the use of color, the use of something symbolic, you know, sometimes it's hard for us to put in words how we feel. Sometimes it's difficult for us to use language. And in times like that, art, colors, they really help because they don't force us to use words. We don't have to explain everything. We don't have to have answers to questions. We can just use color and we can use different forms of art to just express how we feel. So I think the biggest benefit of using art is that you don't have to use words and you don't have to explain everything using language.
Okay. Can I move on to the other question?
Sure.
Okay. So Nidhi is saying, ma'am, you said letting go anything is fine and feel comfortable. But when we let go some things in this fast-paced world, I'm left behind. How do we deal with this?
Okay, so do you mean... Okay. So, I think sometimes we leave things behind, and that is okay. So it really depends, right? Sometimes it's okay to leave things behind because the more we hold on to it, the more it kind of just carries on. There is this whole idea about how, you know, we don't even want to hold on to positive memories because again, then we're stuck in the past. So sometimes it is important to let go of positive or negative or anything at all. But when you think that things are going past really fast and you want to hold on to something, it's just a very simple write it down, you know. And that's something, you know, if you ever attend a webinar also, and I've learned this, if you ever attend a webinar and you feel that, you know, there's so much being said and things are going past and you really want to hold on to anything, just write it down or make a note of it somewhere, you know, so that it's not stuck in your mind, but you have it physically in some space. So I hope that answers your question. I'm not sure. I really hope that that's what you meant.
Okay, so another question, how did you get into expressive art?
Okay, so I'll say the short version of this. And the short version of this is that after I finished college, I did psychology in college, and after I finished college, I wasn't sure what to do. And there was this course in expressive arts, which was done by UNESCO and by Fortis. So I did that course and I discovered that this is exactly what I want to do as a professional. So that's on the professional level. On the personal level, something that I will share today is that whenever I do a session like this, apart from talking to all the participants, I also talk to my younger self. You know, I think that I was not raised, my friends, the people who I know were not raised to express themselves. So I think when you become an adult, it's very difficult to then start expressing yourself. And personally, I found that using art, using writing, using movement, dance, that really helped me express myself and express my feelings. So that's how I got into it personally.
Okay, so Ruby is asking, expressing, acknowledging and feeling better often takes time, and in this world where everyone is running against the clock, taking time for yourself often means falling back on a cord, which piles up and becomes burden. What's the solution to this?
So I completely understand. Thank you so much for that question. I completely understand that. I think that, you know, there's so much that we're all doing every, you know, you all have classes, you may have a lot of other commitments, and sometimes expressing yourself or feeling better or taking out time for yourself seems like it's too much. You don't have time to do that. But I think those are the times when you want to just do these very short activities, you know, whether it's breathing, whether it's, you know, just a little bit. It doesn't have to take away from anything else that's in your plan. It can just be something that you do. So for example, earlier when about a year ago, I used to watch TV for half an hour before I went to sleep. Now, instead of watching TV, I'll write. You know, so you don't have to take away from any other commitment that you have in life. Neither does this have to be another to-do list. So the reason why, you know, I talk about expressive arts is because we want to find mediums to be able to express ourselves. It's not something that's a compulsory thing. Everyone must do some expressive arts every day. Not at all. It's just when you're feeling like you're not having a good day and you want to express yourself, then take out a little bit of time, depending on how much you have, to feel a little bit better. So, as I said, it doesn't have to be another task. Small things, simple things that just bring a smile to your face for that moment. Even something as simple as looking out of the window.
Okay. So, another question is, how to let go of a fake or toxic friend?
Okay, this is tricky. Okay, because the thing is, I wish I could say this is easy, but friendship, like any relationship, is very layered. It's you've had various experiences, and something that someone told me once is that ending a relationship is not easy. And if you change your mind tomorrow and decide that you want to be friends again, that's going to be even harder. So I can't answer the letting go forever, but I think if there is a person in your life who's adding a lot of stress, a lot of toxicity, some of the things you want to do are draw boundaries. And the way you want to draw boundaries is, say, not, let's say, if you keep distance from them on a certain day. So one of the things I do is, like, I'll switch off my phone on a Sunday to just stay away from certain people who will call me all the time or text me all the time, and they're adding more stress to my life. Similarly, just drawing some kind of boundary, making sure you have space for yourself and you're not always with the person. And if you think that the boundaries is not going to help, then sometimes even writing down why you feel that that friend is toxic or fake, and just writing down how you feel about it, reading that, seeing how you feel, helps, because you get clarity about how you feel with that friend. So it comes back to writing, like always. Writing, drawing boundaries, and taking some time, I think, is important.
Yeah, we may take 2-3 questions more. So Rahul is asking, does confrontation always help? I agree that it keeps relationship open and honest, but it can also lead to any misunderstandings and mess up things further, right? How do we know when to talk it out or when to keep the problem to ourselves?
Okay, so that's a very good question. Thank you for that. I have always said that communication is important and expression is important. But as you said, You're absolutely right. Sometimes expressing yourself and being completely honest can lead to misunderstandings. So there are two ways to do this. One is to directly talk to the person, right? Now that depends, as you said, on the relationship you have with the person. If you feel comfortable to talk to the person, you want to tell them how you feel. And the important thing there is to not blame the other person. So if someone said something to me, I want to tell them that I felt hurt. I don't want to tell them you're a horrible person, because they're not a horrible person. I felt hurt. So that's, you know, the language. How do we communicate how we feel is very important. We don't have to get angry and just be mean to the person or insult the person or blame the person, but reflect on how we're feeling. Sometimes you may not feel comfortable, as you said, to speak to that person directly. In those times, and I have done this, I have written, I was very upset with my mother and I wrote her an email, like I drafted it out, right? When I read it, I discovered that I don't need to tell her how I feel, because just writing it down made me feel better. It made me feel like I was heard. So sometimes it's not essential to confront someone or to express our true selves to the person. Because as you said, there can be misunderstandings, but it is important to let those emotions and expressions go and not let them get stuck in your mind. This is also complicated because it depends on, you know, what the issue is, how long it's been affecting you. But, you know, that's where expressive arts comes in, right? Sometimes we can't directly express ourselves to someone. So we use arts. We use different art forms to get a lot of that energy out of our system.
Okay, next maybe we can combine two questions.
Okay.
So Sagarika is asking, do you think it's important to love and focus on yourself before loving others? And Tarunika is asking, don't you think self-love and self-care is an undervalued concept in today's world?
Okay, so self-love and self-care is definitely undervalued. We're always taught as children to care about other people, to be kind towards other people. And if we ever do love ourselves, a lot of people think we're being selfish. So I do think that it is undervalued. At the same time, it is important to draw that line between being selfish and self-care and self-love. So it's always important to take out time for yourself. It's always important to focus on yourself. But it doesn't have to be either or. You know, I personally think you can also love yourself and also love other people, you know, so we don't have to do one at the risk of the other. I think because self-care and self-love is undervalued, we're talking about it a lot more. And I would encourage you to say, I love you to yourself, because it's undervalued. But to answer the second question, you can focus on loving yourself and loving others. I don't think there has to be a before and after. I think you can have it both.
Okay. So Mansi was asking, isn't getting out of your comfort zone an essential step to personal growth?
So is getting out of your comfort zone an essential step for personal growth? I wish, again, this was clear cut. For change to happen, sometimes we need to be uncomfortable and sometimes we have to get out of our comfort zone for personal growth. But I do also think that we can grow with time, you know, and very organically. Also, getting out of your comfort zone is very relative. So for me, maybe getting out of my comfort zone is about experimenting, trying out new things. For someone else, being honest with themselves, being honest with someone else will be getting out of their comfort zone. So to answer your question, yes, it is important sometimes to push ourselves and to try and experiment and really be honest with ourselves. However, I also think that sometimes we believe that we have to take a difficult path to achieve success. It's not necessarily very, very difficult. So you want to get out of your comfort zone, but you don't want to push yourself so hard that you find the impact very, very difficult to deal with. So push yourself a little bit, not too much, is what I would sum it up and say.
Okay, so maybe we'll go to the last question. How do you keep smiling even through various hard times?
Oh, it's not easy. You don't have to also. So if anyone tells you that, oh, you must always smile, that's not necessary. I think that sometimes you are going through something hard and it's okay that you're not smiling. But sometimes you can also fake it. And I'll explain that. So you know how a lot of people say when you're feeling happy and when you're feeling good, then you smile. Sometimes when you're not feeling so good, if you smile, you may start feeling a little better. So you may not feel like smiling, but if you just smile a little bit, you may start feeling a little better. It could happen, but as I said, it's not necessary. If you're having a bad day and you're not able to smile, that's perfectly fine. You'll smile the next day or 5 days later. And smile is not going away anywhere. Don't worry.
Okay, I think we have covered almost all questions. Students, if I have missed out on any questions, you can please say that, and otherwise we'll move to the other part of this program. I hope it's almost done. Lisa, over to you.
Thank you, Sandra. I request everybody to kindly fill out the feedback form given in the chat box. And now I would like to call upon Ms. Heidi Mamta Themelil to propose the vote of thanks.
On behalf of the department, I am happy to propose. First of all, I extend my sincere gratitude to Ms. Michelle Alamsha for sharing her expertise and for her excellent webinar presentation. Michelle, we appreciate the time that you have taken out for this session. Thank you for helping us become more aware of ourselves and in helping us connect better with our feelings through this creative medium of expressive arts. It was truly an empowering session. Thank you very much. And also like to thank our principal, Father Sebastian Mathai, and Vice Principal Father Peter MV for giving us the opportunity to conduct this session. Thank you, Shijo sir, for helping us with the registration procedure and for creating this group for us. The department highly appreciate all the class teachers of second to C for their efforts to publish the event poster, promotion video, and all the required information to their respective classes. Thank you to all participants who registered for this event and for your active participation in the webinar today. We appreciate your questions and your valuable feedback. Finally, my sincere gratitude and thank you to my team for supporting each other to make this webinar a successful one. Once again, thank you all and have a great evening.
So I would like to keep some photographs as a memory for this, session happened. I think all of us are happy, really happy to go do that. And I request some of the students to turn your cameras on. If you could turn your cameras on, we can take a picture. And as Michelle was saying, we can keep it as a good memory of lockdown time. Students,
go ahead.
I think more people can come forward. Yeah. Can I have some three more people? 3 or 6, I guess. I think 2 more people can join. One more person? Yeah, I think one more person can join. Oh, can one more person join? Anyone? Okay. Everyone smile. It's an art therapy session and we all are happy, right? So have a smile on your face. Yeah. One second. Okay. Now, can Pure Ambassadors please turn your cameras on? Pure Ambassadors, all of you turn your camera on.
Okay. Those who were there in the first pick, if y'all can switch it off, please, and allow the others to come on.
Yeah.
Saida and Rohit, you'll be there in the first picture. Can we have someone else instead?
Nikki, I can't see your face. Maybe you can a little more tilt your camera.
Diya, switch on your camera.
Please turn your camera on. Everyone smile. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Now, can we come to the final picture, Lisa?
Sure.
Okay. Can all the department members?
Yeah, Department of Counseling. Everybody, can you please switch on your cameras?
Okay, Malavika, can you switch your Sister camera Nirmala. On?
Sister, yeah, Sister Nirmala.
Okay, suddenly my power went. I'm using my phone light. Okay. Yeah, some of you can take a screenshot also.
Yeah.
One more second. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you all for joining us. We hope you enjoyed the session as much as we did. And thank you all once again for a wonderful time together. I'm sure each one of us is taking a lot from this workshop. Thank you, Michelle.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Michelle.
And you. Michelle, there was a question. Thank when you. Will we have?
Thank
when
you
we
so much.
Having the session again.
Lisa, ma'am.
So I think that the session was really helpful and they really enjoyed. They were asking us when we'll be having it. We'll surely, we'll look forward to that and we'll discuss with, the students and the peers again, peer ambassadors. And yeah, Lisa.
That's it from all of us. And I think we'll take your leave. Thank you for joining us today, Michelle, in such a wonderful workshop. I'm sure each of us has really enjoyed it, and the students will have a lot to ponder upon and reflect. And we'll definitely get in touch with you again, hopefully soon.
Perfect. Thanks a lot. Perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for being here. And as Lisa said, I really hope that everyone can take something back from this session. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.